you're trying to solve the decentralized exchange problem, and BitShares is essentially a new type of cryptocurrency that not only has this distributed exchange mechanism built into it, but that also lets you create new versions of it that track other real world items like, you know, commodities or stocks or things like that. And so in that way, it's like a stock market and a currency market all built into a blockchain like structure. Is that right?
That's exactly right.
Okay, great. Terrific. I'm glad I was able to summarize that. So that's a big project. That's like a holy grail project. People have been trying to solve this decentralized exchange thing for a while, and it seems like it's a tough nut to crack. Where are you in that project and what's next?
Oh, we've been hammering out the details. We've made a lot of progress toward implementing BitShares, but there's a lot of testing and a lot of work that needs to go into it before we can actually release this decentralized bank and exchange for production purposes. But in the meantime, a lot of people have expressed interest in being able to mine BitShares and get involved in BitShares today. So we came up with a concept called ProtoShares. It's sort of like the stem cell of BitShares. It's effectively an altcoin, Litecoin or the others, except it's got a new proof of work, which I'd love to talk about. And it comes with a social contract. And that social contract is that the Genesis block of BitShares will honor one for one. Every protocoin you have, you'll end up with one BitShare. Which means if you're interested in speculating in the future value of BitShares, getting involved, promoting it, you can mine ProtoShares and you can then profit as the value of BitShares grows, as the concept solidifies and more people become aware of how big this is going to be. And it all starts with ProtoShares.
So now we talk to miners and we talk to ASIC manufacturers. Who can actually participate in mining ProtoShares?
ProtoShares is based off of a new proof of work we invented that I call Momentum. And it is limited by the memory bandwidth of your computer, so that even if you were to develop an ASIC, it would not be able to operate any faster than your memory bandwidth. And a desktop CPU can already more or less saturate your memory bandwidth. So the proof of work requires about a gigabyte of RAM to run, which means any ASIC developer would be spending most of their transistors on RAM rather than on additional computational parallelism. As a result, I do not believe it's economically feasible to create specialized ASIC hardware for mining this.
Okay, so what you're saying is that this is targeted towards CPUs specifically, and that this is something where there isn't really an advantage to specializing on the hardware because general purpose hardware is about as specialized as you can get?
Yes, the technology that goes into making RAM as dense as fast as possible is highly patented. It's state of the art. That is the largest component of the Momentum proof of work, is how fast can you address memory and how much memory do you have. So a CPU will be the best miner, provided that it's able to keep up with a memory bus. I've looked into whether or not GPUs can compete, and the PCI Express bus that communicates between your CPU and the graphics is slower than the memory bus. So I do not believe that a GPU could even keep up just because of the bandwidth constraints between the different components on your computer.
We've seen claims like this before from like the script proof of work and things like that, where people claim that they're ASIC proof. But that's kind of like timed exclusive releases these days that you see a lot of times in media. You know what I mean? Like, how long is it's ASIC proof? I mean, like, is that, you know, for a year, for 5 years, for a couple of months? I mean, until it gets worth enough money for someone to develop it?
I believe that, unlike everything that's come before it, this has a much longer shelf life because commodity hardware will continue to improve. I believe it is possible to create an ASIC that will be faster than a CPU by itself. I'm not claiming that's not possible. What I'm claiming is that instead of getting 100x or 1,000 times faster performance at significant power savings, you will only be able to see a 1-2 at most 10x performance gain from creating an ASIC, and that the cost of such an ASIC is going to be primarily the RAM. And therefore, there's not going to be these huge opportunities to profit. And I don't think that an ASIC would entirely displace the value of CPU mining.
real quickly, you know, I'm sitting next to a computer with 16 gigabytes of RAM. Is there an upper limit to how well hardware can do? I mean, is there a cap, or is it just as much RAM as you have, that's how efficient you can be?
Your memory bandwidth is the cap. You only need 1 gigabyte of RAM in order to get the maximum performance. You don't get any from having more RAM. We could tune the parameters of the proof of work for other uses to require more RAM, but we settled on 1 gigabyte as being a nice round number. So yeah, if you have a computer with a gigabyte of RAM that's free and a CPU that's able to saturate the memory bus for communicating to that RAM, you'll have about the best miner you can have. Now there's different speed of RAM. Higher end your motherboard and the more recent your RAM, the better the miner you'll have, but it's not something that's going to grow by orders of magnitude without every computer out there getting the benefit.
Now, why was this something that you decided to do with these ProtoShares? Because, I mean, usually mining serves a couple of purposes, one of which is, frankly, to create and secure the network. So there is no network that ProtoCoins is securing, right?
The ProtoShares network.
ProtoShares, my mistake. But, I mean, this is, again, another way to get people involved with the project and give them a way to participate, right?
But it does two things. Normally, people raise money by pre-mining. If they're trying to create something like what we're doing and there's an opportunity to mine. We didn't want to pre-mine. We wanted to have everyone have an equal opportunity. And the other thing we wanted to be able to do is to establish a market value for BitShares even before they exist, because they'll help us with money to actually develop it. So launching this, we're going to be mining it just like everyone. As the value goes up, the ProtoShares on our books as a company gain value, and that allows us to raise money or potentially sell the ProtoShares that we have mined to raise money.
One of the difficult things about getting involved with a new cryptocurrency a lot of times is, especially when you want to mine, is that if you're not technically savvy or you don't have a background in mining, it can be kind of difficult to set that up. I know that with BitShares, you guys are using an entirely different code base. So I wonder, have you created a new solution for mining, or are you using the standard software?
It's new software for mining because it's a new mining algorithm. But for ProtoShares, it is actually a clone of the latest Bitcoin code base, where the only change that we made was to replace the proof of work and adjust the money supply limited to 2 million. You will be able to download and mine ProtoShares as easily as downloading Bitcoin QT, going to a menu item and saying mine.
Okay, sounds pretty easy.
We plan on having a Windows executable available for download immediately. If you're using Linux, you'll have to compile it from source.
And it won't be available on Mac initially?
I'm working on getting the Mac one as soon as possible. I use a Mac, but I need to work on packaging it up. So we've been doing a lot in this past month since C3. And the main things we have today are you can start buying your QT IDs, and you should visit our website to find out more about how they work and why they're valuable. And you'll be able to start mining ProtoShares. And if you sign up for our newsletter, you can get a heads up of where you can download the latest clients for mining. And of course, we're also going to be launching a beta as soon as possible for QT Mail, which is going to have all the experience of BitMessage, only easier to use. So you'll get to have a feel for the quality of stuff we're trying to produce. And that's what we've been doing.
Well, that sounds like you're making some exciting progress. Daniel, if someone wants to, why don't you give your website again one more time?
You can reach us at invictus-innovations.com.
Daniel Larimer, thanks again for joining us on Let's Talk Bitcoin. We look forward to your continued progress in the space.
Thank you, Adam.
This is Jason King, founder at Sean's Outpost, and you are listening to Let's Talk Bitcoin. Sean's Outpost is a homeless outreach in Pensacola, Florida, and we are proudly powered by Bitcoin. To date, over 13,000 meals have been fed to the homeless in our area, all purchased with Bitcoin and through the generosity of the cryptocurrency community. Read more about us at seansoutpost.com. Food, shelter, Bitcoin, everybody. Sean's Outpost.com.